Treacherous roads have left two lives and left homes damaged as an Arctic blast sweeps across the state. Rain, snow and wild winds have Victorians shivering through the shortest day of the year.
Wet, cold and dangerous, the icy conditions took their toll on Melbourne's roads. Just after 7 this morning, a male pedestrian died after being struck by a truck and a car in Moorabbin.
We just crossed the road and he was coming behind us. And when we go inside, we saw that he was on the road.
Peak hour was a nightmare for train travellers, Blackburn Station's underpass becoming a river. Wild winds did the damage last night, a tree smashing through the roof of this house in Selby. Cars were hit as emergency services worked to keep residents safe.
Look, at this stage we haven't had significant flash flooding or any significant accidents involving trees, but that is a real risk over the next 24 hours as these strong winds and the persistent rain continue.
Fallen trees also halted trains on the Belgrave line. Scarves and brollies were a must for the city's morning rush. An icy start to mark the shortest day of the year.
Winter solstice, mate, so get through shortest day and then it's all uphill from here.
In Antarctica, midwinter is a major celebration.
They'll dig a hole in the ice and they'll get their gear off and go in for a splat.
That may explain this extraordinary behaviour. And when the fishermen are home by the fire, you know it's cold.
When the weather's fine, there can be up to 30 rods in the water out here on St Kilda Pier. Today, it's a case of fortune favours the brave.
Not many out today.
Yeah, not many people, not many scoopers anyway.
The only silver lining to the clouds, plenty of snow in the Alps. Nick Butler, 10 News.
And with more on our big chill, weatherman Mike Larkin joins us live now from Middle Park. And Mike, a bleak day across the state, and as we've seen, some Melbourne suburbs had quite the drenching today.
That's right, Helen, a very good evening. The winter solstice and it felt very wintry. In fact, our coldest day in 5 years, our coldest June day in Melbourne since 1993, our maximum 9.9 after a 9-degree start. Now let's have a look at where the rain has been falling around town during the past 24 hours. Well, in the city, around 16 millimetres of rain has fallen. That's now 49 millimetres for the month of June. That is bang on average for our month. Heavier rain fell in the eastern suburbs, Fernie Creek 33, Scoresby 29, Moorabbin and Coldstream 24 millimetres of rain. Now the rain hasn't gone yet, more activity on the way overnight and tomorrow, so another 10 to 20 millimetres of rain around Melbourne. The wind will ease off tomorrow, skies clearing tomorrow afternoon. All this rain coming across from South Australia, scoring 50 millimetres of rain in 24 hours, their wettest June in 7 years, their wettest 24 hours in some 18 months. I'll have more details in around 25 minutes. Helen?
Thanks for that, Mike. Weatherman Mike Larkin.